I'm Laura from Google. Did you know that you can use the Google Cloud platform to build your own mobile backend on Google's infrastructure in 5 minutes? Let me show you how. In this tutorial, we'll be building an app that allows a user to shop smart by getting information on products she's looking for at the store she's in, as well as find stores nearby. We'll be using some custom code to wire a basic Android app front end with an App Engine Cloud backend using Google Cloud Endpoints, so the phone can determine customer location and the app can locate nearby stores and allow the customer to get relevant offers and recommendations. Let's get started. I've already installed and configured my IDE with all the right tools and SDKs. First, we're going to create the project for the Android client application and start building the app. We'll create an entity class to define the data structure, generate cloud endpoint classes to give us the backend infrastructure and APIs, and then generate a related client library to make calling the server APIs from our mobile app easy. In our Eclipse project, let's create a new class and name it Check-in. These classes allow for communication between the client and the backend. Click to generate the cloud endpoint class. You can see now that the check-in endpoint.java file is generated in our app's backend. To generate the related client library, let's open the Package Explorer and our project. In a few clicks, we generate the check-in endpoint client library. Now that we've created the communication mechanism, we need to add more logic to the mobile client app to talk to the entity and cloud endpoint classes. Once we do this, the app will be able to call back to the server. For our app, this means we'll be able to retrieve store information contained in the backend data store. Let's create a new entity class in our app. This will represent places, such as stores, near the customer's current location in real time. Let's create that new class and name it Place. We'll navigate to the Package Explorer and generate a Cloud Endpoint class. Then, we'll also generate another Cloud Endpoint client library. Now that we've told the app how to understand store addresses, let's modify the client to actually obtain information from the backend and display it in our app. What I'm doing is expanding the mainactivity.java section, where our front-end code is located, and adding in more code, which includes the global results list variable. This contains the information about the store locations obtained from the backend. And now we've got the app infrastructure in place between the client and the mobile backend using Google Cloud Endpoints. We just did a lot. We created a bunch of objects and classes, built the infrastructure, wired up the Android app to call back to the server, and got the app to display a list of stores. Next, let's add logic that allows the customer to perform the actual tasks of checking into a place and obtaining information about the sales and offers. First, we need to create the client user interface so users can access the information. Then we can add offers and recommendations logic to the backend and to the client. Let's modify a few files to improve the interface. We replace text view with list view, which contains the code to list nearby places. We add the places list click listener event handler, which helps the client understand user clicks and lets it know when to activate the logic that performs the check-in tasks. Finally, in the onPost execute method, we create a list adapter to better display the information with icons. Let's now add a few things to the mainactivity.java file to improve the interface even more. We add activityMain.xml, which defines the UI layout for buttons and places. We add placeItem.xml, which contains information about display format and position. And finally, we add strings.xml, which contains predefined strings to display when the user might get relevant offers or recommendations. Now that we've created the client user interface, we need to add classes that allow the app to obtain information about offers available and shopping recommendations for each store. We can add the offer.java entity class and the recommendation.java entity class, one for gathering offers and one for gathering shopping recommendations. In the same way we added the checkin.java class, we're going to create our related offerEndpoint.java class and recommendationsEndpoint.java class. Again, this creates the related client libraries automatically. Finally, we're going to add the logic to the client so that the customer can actually see offers and shopping recommendations displayed. We modify mainactivity.java to add the places list click listener event handler so that when a customer clicks on an item in the list of nearby places, it'll provide offers and recommendations. We're done with all the coding. Let's deploy an instance to see our app live. Check it out. In 5 minutes, we were able to control our Android app by writing custom code to wire the app to Google Cloud Endpoints, enhancing the user experience and saving us time. Now, you should go download the code and the tutorial and give it a shot doing it on your own.